Good morning. In today's PE lesson, we are going to be doing a sprint start. A sprint start will be used in 100, 200 and 400 meter races in athletics. To start with, it's important that we know which is your dominant foot. So it'll either be which foot you kick the football with, or a way we can work this out is if you turn side on and you're going to lean forwards, whichever foot you put out in front of you is naturally going to be your strongest foot or your dominant foot. So for me, that would be my right foot, okay? So if you want to give that a go and see which is your stronger foot. Next thing we need to do is create ourselves a start line. So I've used a towel, okay? But if you've got something like a skipping rope at home that you can place on the floor, that's what we need to do next. Now I've created my start line using my towel. All right, the next thing I need to do is, because the sprint start is going to be from a crouched position, I need to work out where my feet are going to place. So the first thing I'm going to do is, with my non-dominant foot, so for me that's my left leg, okay, my left foot, I'm going to place that up to the line. I'm not going to be on the line because that would be a foul in athletics and I would be disqualified. It must be behind the line. I'm then going to place my dominant foot to create a T just behind. Okay, this is to help me measure the distance. All right, and then I will then place my non-dominant foot behind again, and that will give me the correct distance that I need from the start line. Okay, so to get into my on your marks position, okay, I've got my non-dominant foot the correct distance from the line. I then need to think about where I'm going to place my dominant foot. So it needs to be about a fist width, okay, that far away from the inside of my knee, so not too big of a gap between my feet. Okay, so I'm going to kneel further back, and I know that I've got a distance between the heel of my foot and my knee. Okay, so I'm happy with that. The next thing I need to do is think about my hands. Where am I going to place my hands? So I'm going to use my fingertips and the tips of my thumbs, okay, and I'm going to place those just in front of the line, all right, and I'll be up on the balls of my feet so my arms are perpendicular, and that means nice and straight. Okay, so I'm now in this loaded position, okay? The weight is on my fingertips and my back is slightly rounded, okay? It's straight at the bottom but slightly rounded to the top. The next thing I will be thinking about is ready for that set call. And that is when I will straighten my back leg into more of a ready position, okay? Am I keeping my head down, ready to explode out the blocks. Now in the set position, my legs are ready to fire out the blocks. I'm just listening for that go. Okay, once I do that, I'm gonna be traveling from a low to high body position. So I'm gonna keep my head down. My legs are gonna be firing the whole time and working my way up into my running stance. So the reason that we would use this stance for sprinting is to generate a lot of force to get us out the blocks nice and quickly. All right, so I'm now gonna put this together and show you how it should look when I do it all together, okay, and ready to start the race. I'm now going to show you what that will look like over the first 10 and 20 meters of a race. So that first 10, I'm going to focus on keeping my head down, okay? Lots of force generated into the floor, lots of generating lots of power. And then I'm going to be thinking more about my running flow, coming up nice and straight, getting my head up, and really thinking about my running action, okay? So this is how it should look. How to do a sprint start that we would use for 100, 200, 400 meters. We'd love to see you having a go, so send us some pictures and videos of you doing that at home, and watch out for Miss Laybourne's lesson next time on Reaction Time. Have a good day. Bye bye.